We've lost more family members to the sea. Picking up our loved one remains like shells off the beach. It affects you. And I know that it affects all the other 13 family who calls Masig home, that they are all facing the same situation, the same problem, mentally, physically, and spiritually. I shed tears of joy. My people here shed tears of joy, my elders especially. It was an awesome feeling. A feeling that we know that the doors now has been opened. The government will listen to us, our cries.
The ruling paves the way for other people from climate-vulnerable communities around the world to hold their governments to account. The Australian government must take this decision as a sign that they need to double down on climate action. And then that also needs to be applied to other countries in Australia, because, of course, the ruling may not apply just to Torres Strait Islanders, but it could apply to other vulnerable communities around the country.
This fight has gave me hope. This win has gave me hope, knowing that my future generations and their generations to come in 100 years from now, that they will remain on their home, they will practice their culture and their tradition, that they will celebrate the rich culture and tradition of their country, the island where they call home. We really want the government to come up to our home, sit with us so we could discuss further in how we could make a safer